I have some assets that we will use to create the animation. I will provide this in the description. So import all of them. I have a character, some newspaper parts, and music, which is compulsory. There's also a background. The background is short in the duration, so to extend it, we will open its layer in the project panel. Click on interpret footage, go to main, and set the loop value to 2. Now it's extended. The photo is larger than the frame, so we'll select it and use the pen tool to mask it to the frame size like this. Now I will rename all these layers so everything is organized. This one is the character. This is our paper, this is ace, and so on. Name them however you like. This is the wing, and there shall be 2 wings. So I will duplicate it to create a left wing and right wing. And lastly, this is my background. I will move this right wing to the right side of the character. I don't like the color of the background, so we will add an effect to it. Hue and saturation from here. We can change the color by adjusting the values. I want to make it red, also increase the saturation. Now we will add markers on the timeline according to the music beats. I will trim the layer on the left side of the first marker and also on the right side of the last marker, but not the music. Customize all of these with different colors so that it's easier to find out and identify them. Select this wing and apply an effect to it, which is glow. I will quickly go over the settings. Set the threshold to 20% and the radius to 35, and set the glow colors to A and B colors. I will make both colors option red because that's our theme, but you can choose as you like. Now duplicate this glow effect and set the radius of the second glow to 400, so it will look like this. Now copy these effects and paste them onto the other wing. Now select this character and use the pen tool to create mask around it. I won't make it fit perfectly, otherwise it will become a cutout. On this same character layer, we will add an effect, call it Saber. Go into its settings, open customize core and set core type to layer mask. Then go to render settings and set the composite settings to 8. Now we'll go to the preset and select electric. It will look something like this. According to our theme, we will change the glow color to red. The effect is too prominent on the top of the layer, so I will duplicate it and delete the Saber effect from the upper layer. Now the effect will appear behind the character, which looks better. Now I will select the right wing and move its anchor point to the character's shoulders. We need to do the same thing for the left wing. Next, select both wings and open its rotation property. Click on the stopwatch to add keyframe. When we tick this point, we can only see that layers. It shows a tick mark which makes working easier. I will also hide the character by unticking it. Now we can only see the wings. In the initial keyframe, we will keep the wings bent like this. At the end of the layer, we will raise the wing as if they are ready to fly. Select all the keyframes. Open the graph editor, create a curve like this and apply it. It will look something like this. Let's move on to the next task. We need to write some text here. We will keep the chapter text small and align it properly. This text looks a bit plain, so I want to add a glow effect to it. And set the radius to 100. For now, I will hide this text because I need to create a lightning behind it. Using the pen tool, I will create this shape. Then go to its content, shape, fills, and set the opacity to 0. Then next, go to the stroke and increase the stroke width to 10 units. So it will look like a line. Now I will go to that and add a trim path. Open the trim path settings. Move the timeline to the point where text start. Initially, the text start and the end values will be 0. I will add a keyframe for both Then I will move half a second forward on the timeline and set both of value to 100. Select the upper keyframe and move it slightly to the side, like this. Now let's add another effect, wiggle path. Set the size to 25, detail to 5, and its random set. Click on the stopwatch while holding the Alt button and type time into 10. Now add an effect to this line, turbulent displace. Set the amount to 80 and the size to 40. Finally, add a glow effect. Set the intensity to true and then duplicate this glow effect. Increase the radius of the second one to 50. Now I will shorten this line by trimming it because I don't need it to be too long. Then I will duplicate it and add a fill effect to the second one. Setting its color to red. I will move this layer slightly forward in the timeline. Next, I will unhide the text layer and place it above the lightning layer. I will also trim the text from the left side. Going into Animation Composer, I will add some animation to this text, making it look like this. Now I need to write the title, so I will duplicate this text to avoid the writing it again. I will place it at this point. We will also duplicate the lightning layers and position them accordingly for the next text. I will move this text and lightning down and make them bigger. Write your chapter 1 topic and increase its size. We forgot to add an effect, drop shadow, because the text is still not clear. I will set the opacity to 100% and softness to 50. I will copy this effect and paste it onto the chapter 1. There are some extra at the end, so we will trim that. Select this text, go to the Animation Composer and add an effect that make it slightly bigger. Do the same thing for the other text. The next task is to categorize all this layer. So let's start. I will link the lightning layers to their respective text layer so that when I move the text, the lightning move with it. Next, I will link the wings and the lightning behind the character to the front PNG of the character. Then I will go to the new, add a camera layer. Trim it on the both side according to the marker. Turn on the 3D option for all this layer. Increase the screen size and set the view to 2 view. Set the left screen to top and keep the right screen as active camera. Now I will move all this layer back in the Z direction. First I will select the background and move it far back as I am doing now. We forget to link the face to the frame as well. Now I will share a secret. For all connected layers, click on this button. I will explain why later. I will click on the shape layers, the back part of the character, the wings, and the face. Since they are connected, when I turn this option on, all connected layers will be hidden. This makes it easier to work without unnecessary layer cluttering the view. Only keep the layers needed in the timeline. Let's continue with our task. Select the layers and move them back in the Z direction. Space them out a bit as well, not all at the same distance. I will also move the character slightly back. And the all paper layer a bit back. I will link the chapter 1 to the topic text and hide it by clicking on this button. select the text and move it back closer to the background. Now I will divide this camera layers into three parts according to these points. So we will have three different scenes. For scene 1, let's adjust everything. For example, I will position the character here and adjust the background size to fit completely. I will also adjust the papers to their correct places and increase their size. For a moment, I will move the text forward so we can see it clearly and customize it. I will move the text slightly above the character and make it larger. After making this adjustment, we will move the layer back to its original position. Now go to the endpoint of the camera 1 and add keyframe for the position, point of interest and Z rotation by clicking on the stopwatch. Next, move to the starting point of the camera. Make some adjustment to the camera position, rotation like this. I will select all this keyframe and create a flow like this, then apply it. We need to do the same for the other two cameras. Go to the endpoint of the second camera and add a keyframe for the position and the point of interest. The camera position here will be different. Since positioning it exactly on the screen might be challenging, I will set it from the top to the right. Focus the camera on the text and make some adjustment to the point of interest to give the camera angle a bit of a tilt. Move to the starting point of this camera and make few changes. Select all the keyframes and apply the same flow as before. Now, go to the endpoint of the third camera and add keyframe for point of interest, position and Z rotation. Adjust the camera position so that the text, character and all elements are visible. Move to the starting point of this camera. Make some adjustment to the position, rotation and apply the same flow to the all keyframe as done previously. I'm noticing that the background looks a bit dark here, so I will increase its size a bit more. For a moment, I will hide all three cameras and set the view back to one view. Now I will select all the papers and add keyframe for their positions at the endpoint. And then go to the starting point to make slightly adjustment to their position. I need to add an effect to these papers, directional blur. Set the blur length to 10. Then copy this effect and apply it to all the papers. After doing this, we will unhide the cameras. I have an overlay that I will add according to this marker. I will position it well on the screen. Go to its blending options and set it to the linear dodge. And this is our animation is ready. We will continue creating similar animations and more videos will keep coming. See you in another video. Until then, goodbye.